The five loaves. What have I got against him? I'll tell you frankly, neighbor. It's not that I have anything against this teaching. Not at all. I listened to him preach once, and believe me, I came close to becoming one of his followers myself. I went back home and told my cousin, the saddlemaker. You really ought to hear him. In his own way, he's a prophet. He speaks beautifully, no doubt about it. It makes your heart turn right over. I'm telling you, I had tears in my eyes. I'd have willingly closed up my shop then and there and followed him as to never let him out of my sight. Give away all you have, he said, and follow me. Love your neighbor. Help the poor. Forgive those who wrong you. Things like that. I'm just an ordinary baker, but when I listened to him, there was such a strange joy and pain within me. I don't know how to describe it. Such a weight inside that I could have fallen to my knees and wept. Yet at the same time, I felt so fine and light, as if everything had fallen away from me, all my cares and anger. So I said to my cousin, "You dummy, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. All you can talk about is money, who owes you what, and how you have to pay all those tithes and markups and interest. You ought to give everything you have to the poor, leave your wife and children, and follow him. And as for his curing the sick and the possessed, I don't hold that against him either. True, it's a strange and unnatural power, but still, everybody knows that our surgeons are self-serving bunglers, and those Roman ones aren't any better. They're good at taking your money, but when you call them to tend the dying, they just shrug their shoulders and say you should have called them sooner. Sooner. My late wife was sick for 2 years with a hemorrhage. I took her to one doctor after another. You can't imagine the money it cost. And not a one of them was any help to her. If he'd been going from town to town then, I'd have fallen on my knees before him and said, 'Lord, heal this woman,' and she'd have touched his robe and been healed. I can't begin to tell you how that poor thing suffered. So, that's what I praise him for, curing the sick. The quacks are all crying out against it, you know. They say it's fraud and meddling and they want him stopped and whatnot. But you've got all kinds of interests at work here. Anyone who wants to help people and save the world is bound to bump up against somebody else's interests. You can't please everyone. It isn't possible. I say, let him heal folks and maybe even raise the dead. But he shouldn't have done what he did with those five loaves of bread. I'm telling you, as a baker, that was a great injustice to bakers. You didn't hear about that business with the five loaves of bread? I'm surprised at that. All the bakers are absolutely beside themselves over the affair. Well, they say a great multitude followed him to a desert place, and he healed their sick. And when it was evening, his disciples came to him, saying, 'This is a desert place, and the time is now past. Send the multitude away, that they may go into the villages and buy themselves victuals.' But he said unto them, 'They need not depart. Give them to eat.' And they say unto him, 'We have here but five loaves and two fishes.' He said, 'Bring them hither to me.' And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass, and took the five loaves and the two fishes, and looking up to heaven, he blessed, and broke, and gave the loaves to his disciples, and the disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat, and were filled. And they took up of the fragments that remained 12 baskets full. And they that had eaten were about 5,000 men, beside women and children." Admit it, neighbor. No baker's going to stand for that. How could he? If it gets to be standard practice for somebody or other to feed 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fishes, then bakers would be put out to pasture. Am I right? Forget about those fishes. They grow all by themselves in the water, and anyone who wants to can catch them. But a baker has to buy flour and firewood at high prices. He has to have an assistant and pay him wages. He has to maintain a shop. He has to pay taxes and what have you. And in the end, he's glad if he has a few pennies left over to live on, just so he doesn't have to go out begging. But he just looks up to heaven, and he's got enough bread for 5 or who knows how many thousand people. Flour costs him nothing. He doesn't have to have firewood hauled from God knows where. No expenses. No work. Well, Of course he can give people bread for free, can't he? And he never even thinks about the fact that he's depriving local bakers of an honest, hard-earned profit. It's unfair competition, I tell you, and he's got to be stopped. Let him pay taxes like us if he wants to run a bakery. People are already coming to us and saying, how come you're asking such an unchristian amount of money for one lousy little loaf? You should give it away for free, like he does, and the good kind, like his bread is said to be. So white, crunchy, and sweet-smelling, you can eat yourself to death on it. We've already had to knock down prices as it is. On my honor, we're offering baked goods at less than cost just to keep from closing our shops. If things go on this way, it'll be the end of the bakery business. They say that at some other place he fed 4,000 men beside women and children from 7 loaves and 2 small fishes. But they only took up 4 baskets of fragments there. It may be that his business isn't going so well after all. But he's ruining us bakers for good. And I'm telling you right now, he's only doing it out of hostility to us bakers. Of course, the fishmongers are crying out against him too, but they charge outrageous prices for their fish, you know. It's just not as honest trade as ours. Look here, neighbor, I'll be an old man before long, and I'm all alone in this world. I have neither wife nor child, so there's not a thing I need. I've already told my assistant that he's stuck with my bakery now. There is no profit for me in staying here. In truth, I'd rather give away my few measly possessions and follow him and cultivate love for my neighbors and everything else he preaches. But when I see the stand he's taking against us bakers, I tell myself, oh, no, you don't. I can see as a baker that this is no redemption of the world, but a ready-made disaster for our trade. I'm sorry, but I can't let him get away with it. It won't do. Naturally, we filed a complaint against him with Annas and with the governor for interfering with trade regulations and for disturbing the peace. But you know how these officials take forever to get anything done. You know me, neighbor. I'm a peaceable man, and I don't go seeking quarrels with anyone. But if he comes to Jerusalem, I'll stand out in the streets and shout, "Crucify him! Crucify him!"